I'm not going to ask you to give away your game plan, Graham, but it's one thing to sort of beat the top teams home and away, and as you know it all too well, then doing it in a pressure cooker situation at the Olympics, because out there the margins are extremely fine.
Yeah, and that's elite sport, you know. That's why we love it so much, you know. Every sport has that unknown factor that no one knows what's going to happen. So we have to make it happen. And we were doing a webinar the other day, and it reminded me of a couple of stories, but one of them was the World Cup in 2010 in Delhi, and Australia was playing Germany, and I happened to be on the bench coaching. Rick was up in the stands, and we were 1-0 up against the Germans. The Germans came back to 1-1, you know, and it was like, bring it on, let's go, boys, you know. It was let's. Now we stand up. Now we have a game, you know. And I was sort of reminding Manpreet the other day that's what happened in Pro League, for example, in the game against Holland. We were 3-1 down with three quarters. You know, we had someone off the pitch, so we were at 10 men, and they were just coming on. And we said, right, we're now back to 11. Let's go. You know, we can. And it was great to see the boys lifted, and you know, we got back to 3-all. Could have been 4-3 in the last minute, the last 10 seconds, and we took it to shootouts and won. And they're the sort of experiences that I think really is what ends up, counting against what we know this team can do.
Since you mentioned shootouts, I'll go to the shootout king. Srijesh, no easy games at the Olympics or the World Cup, as Graham was mentioning. But what was the sort of team's reaction when you saw the groupings for Tokyo? Argentina, Australia, New Zealand, Spain and Japan, who pipped you to the gold at the Asian Games in Jakarta?
As Manpreet already mentioned about this, when it comes to Olympics games or World Cup, it's really tough to judge any team with their performance, because when they are they're on that particular day on the field, they just give their 200% to win that match and to make it to the quarterfinals or into the semis or finals. So from the team, when you take it like Japan, they are having the advantage of their own home ground, and definitely with the weather. When it comes to Australia, they are dominating now in the pro leagues. When it comes to Argentina, they will come to the games with the previous 2016 gold medal memory. So it's not so easy for us. And definitely we missed playing against New Zealand and Spain recently. But still, I believe that it's the last 1.5 years, what we've done here in Bangalore, how hard we trained. So we just need to look into ourselves, how hard we worked, how better we prepared. Now is the time for execution. And there is no chance for us to regret after this tournament. So definitely this all sacrifice, what we made from last 1.5 years, is going to pay us a great support in the Olympics Games, and I believe that we can achieve it.
Okay, I like that optimism. You know, Manpreet, earlier Indian teams, and I don't mean any disrespect here, but they would have looked at the draw, and I've followed a fair bit of hockey, and you know, they would have said in your Punjabi, Ando, or simply as the coach said, bring him on. Now, as part of your preparation, do you specifically prepare for each team in the build-up?
Yes, actually last 1.5 years we've been watching every single team. We've been, you know, analyzing them really closely, that we should know that if we are playing with the Australia, what is their strength, what is their weakness, which is their key players. So we've been working out, and until now we are like, we having every players having their data, that okay, fine, I'm going playing with the Australia today, so these are the players, it's good. So how are we going to defend them? We will watch the videos. Yes, this is the way we're going to stop them. So we have been analyzing every single team. So at least we feel that we are prepared for that. As Shiri said that, like, we're going to do our best. We're going to give up 200% every single matches.
Okay, Graham, I'm going to throw that to you as well, because, you know, unlike football, and we're seeing that right now, where there is a gap in tournament play, the Olympics are relentless, sort of 7 games in 14-15 days, if you have to go all the way. Then it's going to be hot and humid as well in Tokyo.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be a tough 7 or 8 days. So yeah, that's one of the factors, of course, that we have been thinking about for a long time. It's one of the reasons where we have been really focusing on our fitness. That we were there in 2019 for the test event, and then we realized how humid it is, and it may not necessarily even be that hot. You look at the weather forecast, for example, and it doesn't look that hot, but you get there and it is, you know, that humidity is sometimes above 80%, and that can eat away at your And then this time also, we normally you have a game and then you have a day off and then you have another game. This time we have two back to back, so they're all factors that we have to come to terms with. I think every training session we say this is nothing, this is nothing compared to Tokyo. It's going to be hot.